Massive protests have swept across Israel in the wake of the deaths of six hostages in Gaza. Hundreds of thousands of people have taken to the streets for a second day, the country nearly being brought to a halt from anger at the lack of a ceasefire deal.
While the fighting grinds on in Gaza, tens of thousands of Israelis hit the streets of Jerusalem, Tel Aviv, and other big cities. Following those protests was a general strike called by Israel's biggest union, demonstrating against the deaths of six Israeli hostages last week and calling on Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu to make a deal to end the fighting and get the remaining captives home. But the strike wasn't observed by all workers, reflecting the growing political divide here.
There's no need to punish the whole state of Israel because of what is happening. It is a victory for Hamas. We think it is justified and it is necessary, even if it delays our flight or impacts some of our time.
Ceasefire talks are continuing at lower levels, with diplomats working to hammer out the final details. The protesters say they want Netanyahu to resign so that a lasting peace deal can be reached, but most experts say that's unlikely.
Netanyahu's position is volatile, but he has managed to stay in power for the past 11 months.
But that's not stopping families of the remaining hostages to pressure both the Israeli and U.S. governments to cut a deal, claiming the idea of a total victory over Hamas is unrealistic at this point.
Hearing from our government that, you know, a little more military pressure and a little bit more military pressure is going to cause Hamas to come begging for an agreement and an exchange of our hostages, clearly that has not happened.
On Monday, Israel's labor court ruled the strike is illegal because it's politically motivated and ordered workers back to their jobs.
Yeah, and you might have been watching on the bottom right-hand corner of your screen there. We'll just enlarge on that because things look to have become a little heated, more so than they already have been, as police try and control those protesters. That's live in Jerusalem as we speak. Yeah, a lot of cameras up at the moment, which means that the shots are freezing depending on which shot we are taking. That one seems to be a little cooler. But we'll keep watching that for you, folks. Let's just take a little audio to see how loud things are getting. Yeah, so as we said yesterday, there were 500,000 protesters on the streets of Tel Aviv, as well as Jerusalem, as these ongoing stoushes continue between the protesters and police. Yeah, police are really having a tough time of things, controlling things at the moment, because there's just so many protesters. So 500,000 people yesterday. The estimate today is that there's hundreds of thousands out there as well today. And what this is all about, of course, is that they want a better deal. They want a deal to be done as soon as possible, blaming Benjamin Netanyahu for it and the slow progress for getting those other 100 hostages out. But as we spoke to a few people on this program yesterday, the folks here, as frustrated as they are, and deservedly so, it's Hamas who is holding them. Hamas are the ones who are holding those hostages. So if you've just joined us, folks, these pictures are coming to us right now in Jerusalem. It's been another day of protests, the second in a row. 500,000 people protesting yesterday, today another couple of 100,000 as well. These pictures coming to us from Jerusalem, and this all comes off the back of the Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, who's asking for forgiveness over the hostages' deaths, the six of them, but is remaining firm against Hamas, like we were saying. So speaking to the protesters a little earlier today, the Prime Minister vowed the militant group would pay a heavy price for the massacre of the Israelis. Mr. Netanyahu says he's fully committed to a hostage deal, but the nation must have control over the Philadelphia corridor, as he made clear at the ceasefire talks.
We will ensure our existence and our future. Together we stand, together we fight, and together, God willing, we will win.